I'm taking my first look at Tim Holtz's new alcohol pearls, playing with the colors and creating swatches. In today's video, I'll show you a little about them and show you the swatches I created in our new 3-inch by 4-inch Yupo disc bound journal. When I was at Creativation and watched Tim demo with and speak about the alcohol pearls, I noticed the color swatches he was holding. Each is a rectangle of Yupo with a hole punched on one end, and they were fastened together with a book ring. The swatches were simply a puddle of each color, but together as a whole, they make a great reference. Of course, I'm all about disc binding, and the first thing that came to my mind was to create a Yupo version of our 3x4 disc-bound journal, which is what you see here. I like that this is a swatch book, and it allows me to work like I would in any of our disc-bound journals, which means easy in and easy out of pages. So let's say, for example, I've got this out and I want to remove this page of Smolder. I'm going to put my non-dominant hand on the page opposite of the one I want to take out, and then I'm going to grab the page I do want to remove. I'm going to hold it in this top corner up by the discs, and then it's just a matter of pulling up and back toward me. And then to put them back in, you'll just align the notch over the disc and snap it right back into place. So when you work with these, the first thing that you're going to notice, or hopefully the first thing that you'll notice, is that there are mixing balls, and I'm going to shake these at the same time. These have only been sitting a couple of minutes, but you can see the pearl pigment has begun to accumulate in the bottom. So you want to give them a shake and let that mixing ball do its job. And then when you have it open and sitting, if you let it sit for a minute or two, what I generally do is not put the cover back on. I just come and put my finger over the tip of the bottle and give it a quick shake to be certain that the pigment is mixed up. So if you turn this upside down and you go completely vertical or perpendicular to the table, you're going to notice that there's one drop just kind of hanging there. And I can push, but that mixing bowl has a tendency to go all the way down to the end, and sometimes no matter how hard you push, the mixing bowl is kind of blocking the opening to the needle tip. It's much easier, or at least I find it easier, to keep the bottle about horizontal to the surface of the table, which keeps the mixing bowl out of there, and then you can just kind of put drops on that way. I think that that's a little bit easier than going straight up perpendicular to the table. I find it much easier to work that way. So the journals themselves, let me bring my swatch back in. We're going to give you 20 3x4 Yupo pages and 4 of the 3/4-inch discs, which means you can add other pages to this. And if you want to swap them out for the larger 1-inch discs, of course, you can do that too. Now, you can do more than make swatches in this journal, of course. And before I forget, so coming back to the journal, as with everything that we sell, bar a couple of things, the everyday discount of 15% will be automatically applied to the price of this by the website. Okay, so back to something more than swatches. The sky is the limit. Anything you want to do on these pages, you can certainly do. So I've started with another section here. These are my pearl tests and experiments. And I made a note about what I did here. And then someplace here is another one that I did. So one of the first things that you'll notice, or at least that I noticed, is that, and I'm just going to give these a quick shake, is that pearls tend to mix much more than alcohol inks do. When you put orange on top of pink with just the straight alcohol inks, they're going to push each other around a little bit, but they don't mix a super lot. But if you watch me put the pink, so that is Intrigue, I think, and this is Splendor. If I put another drop in here, you can see what's going to happen is that I'm getting a color change. It's now neither of the original colors, it's a blend of the others. So you're going to get mixing in a more traditional paint-like fashion with pearls than what you get with alcohol inks themselves. Now the other thing that I'm going to, again, this is just a quick observational moment here. There'll be other videos coming about pearls, but the other thing that I wanted to show you is that blending solution is kind of like magic. So if I put this out and I grab my bottle of blending solution, which is here somewhere, if I could put my hands on it, where did it go? Oh, here it is. Okay, so blending solution. Of course, don't forget that in addition to this standard 2-ounce bottle, the blending solution is now available in a 1/2-ounce bottle, like the size of the ones that the pearls themselves are in. So I can put some blending solution on here, and you can see what happens. It starts to break the pearl away from the color. It allows lots of movement, and interestingly enough, you can get these colors of pearls to kind of blend a little bit. And then if I were to come in with a heat tool, see the striations in the pearl there? And if I hold it to you, it's going to move. But you can see these striations that form. If you come in with a heat tool Now this is Yupo, is plastic, so you want to apply that gently. But if you come in with a heat tool, you can kind of get this to set up and you can start to capture some of those patterns that are in there. So if I do that, so here's the other thing I wanted to show you. If I take Intrigue and Tranquil, I'm going to put them together and get a purple. Now it's close to Villainous, but if I had added more pink or more Tranquil, it would lean either toward the pink or the blue side of purple. So coming back to my blending solution, you can see that I did come in and heat this, and you can see that I have captured some of that patterning, some of the pathways that seem to get formed as those pearls move around with the help of the blending solution. So this really is just the barest beginning, but with a swatch and test book in hand, you can experiment and play around, and then you can record and store your results in your Yupo swatch book.